In the New Testament, certainly Jesus says this, take this wine. He's already had a sip, whatever. In the Old Testament, they are told, the Bible actually says, do not become a drinker of water only, but take some wine for your ailments, as in like if you have some bad back or something. So when did it become haram and why did Allah change his mind?
That's why in Islam now I'm saying it's forbidden for me to drink alcohol because alcohol, it clouds the mind. And
so why did
I'm
Jesus make
the mind,
it?
I can,
why did Jesus turn the water into wine?
He turned it into that meat.
But it's halal for him.
No, no, it's not about he make it. Wine, you can maybe sip.
He drank it as well.
Yeah, yeah, he drank it, but not to
a
level that he is clouded. Yeah. Man.
But then because, but alcohol is completely haram for you. Not one sip is not good.
No, no.
You can't do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but because there are some people will be able to control themselves, and some other, when they have some disaster in their life, they will rely on the alcohol to forget even themselves. Sure. And you can see the society, it become gambling, drunken, and broken family, and lead to destruction of the family. And this is why Quran actually forbid the alcohol, because alcohol, it's the door for bigger,
so what
bigger
happens,
disaster.
Okay, so I've got a couple of things. One, when you look at a woman and have desire, yep, whether you turn your mind away from that,
okay,
the Bible says you've still committed adultery in your heart. So my only point in making that is it's our nature, and the Bible knows that. Yep. The Bible doesn't condemn us for it. Okay. It just tells us that you will need forgiving for that. And Paul says, if you feel like you can't master this lust, get married.
Yeah.
But he says, if you don't want to, don't want it. Yeah. But hold on, okay. What were you talking about a second ago? Ah, shucks, I forgot the...
I talk about the alcohol.
Alcohol. So what happened in the 600 years between the New Testament and Muhammad? Because when Allah revealed the Torah and the Injil and the Psalms, alcohol was not haram in any of those, anything in those. He says... in the New Testament, certainly Jesus says this, take this wine. He's already had a sip, whatever. In the Old Testament, they are told, the Bible actually says, do not become a drinker of water only, but take some wine for your ailments, as in like if you have some bad back or something. So when did it become haram and why did Allah change his mind?
You know, everything in this life is a test and trial. This is why we say that the Quran actually it contains the previous scripture and contains them and bring a new law to people, because everything comes step by step. For example, even at the time of other prophet and messenger, it's not allowed that you go and drink, because drink and over a drink will, as I said, cloud your mind and you...
When did it become haram?
It became haram when...
When the Prophet came.
When the Prophet came, and bit by bit he forbid it. And he said, stay away from the step of shaitan, because al-khamar... The alcohol will make you lose your mind,
senses,
and you cannot even stand in prayer, yeah, because you don't know what you're saying.
Yeah, you'll be falling on your face.
Because actually, if
that would be all right for Muslim prayers, though. Just straight down.
If somebody drank, he can do adultery, he can do killing, he can do whatever, because his mind is absent.
But the Bible's a bit different. The Bible says that it's stone cold sober. If I look at a man with lust, it doesn't actually say that. It says, if you look at a woman with lust, you have already sinned in your heart. You've already done more than that. Muhammad started to prohibit alcohol, step by step, he got a bit more. Because I hear what you're saying is maybe some of his reason was you might commit adultery, you might become like blasphemous, idolatrous, or something else, like a gateway. But what I'm saying to you is, Isa, I guess that Muslims hold to the story that he created the wine in the, you know, the first miracle of Jesus was the making wine. Not to get people drunk, because it was a wedding, to celebrate, to toast glory to the God and to everyone else. So what I'm saying is there a story in the Quran where God changed his mind? Allah say only Muslims can't drink, or does Allah say no one?
No, Islam come to... to bring all people into
submission,
doing the will of God and submitting to Him. And as long as God, He create us and He create everything for us. And this is what I'm saying. There's a trial in every single issue in the world. For example, a woman, when she look, she cannot as well desire a man.
No.
To be, no?
No, no, lust.
So only men.
No, well, he was talking. Woman. Hold on.
What I'm saying.
Yeah, go.
Before I forget. The forbidding of the alcohol is to preserve the family and preserve...
That's the reasons for it. What
you're asking, God changed His mind before. Even before, like at the time of Jesus, Jesus turned the water into wine, not people to get drunk, to
bash. Drunkenness is a sin in the Bible, I've got it. But to drink one glass of wine is not a sin, you see?
Okay.
So I'm asking you, if Jesus was, if Jesus was pure and of Allah, like if he was a holy dude, then he definitely made wine. He didn't make it so people would sin or get drunk. What I'm saying is, in those time between Muhammad and Jesus, God must have said, "Oh, do you know what? It's better if I just say no one's allowed."
Okay,
you see?
I will agree with you, and I don't want to just argue for nothing.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is,
most
of the problem come from alcohol, and actually,
and most of the problem comes from sin, though.
Because people, when they fall in trouble, and they start to get
worship idols,
and bit by bit. By bed, they leave their children, they gamble their house. At the time of Prophet Muhammad, they used to drink and they gamble about
running around naked.
They gamble even
for
their family, and they give their wealth, and they lose everything.
Yeah.
And this is why God forbid the alcohol and
alcohol,
want
sorry.
People to know what they are doing. And how they obey God and
so let me just double check this because we are wrapping it up now, but that would suggest that in Saudi Arabia there's no one losing their family or gambling or but there is. So even just taking alcohol out, it's not the whole thing. We have to turn to God in everything. So quick wrap up, because I'm freezing. I mean literally wrap up with my coat. Go on.
The wrap up is that God sent prophet and messenger and guidance, constitution through his book for us to be better human among ourselves, among our family, among our society, and he wants the best for us. And all what we need to do just to come back to him and love, to love him with all our, and yeah.
Okay, brilliant. So my little wrap up is, it's absolutely freezing. I don't know if anyone didn't catch that it's freezing. But the reason we need to go back to God, as Yahya rightly says, the reason is that we separated ourselves from God by our forefathers, at least, our ancestors, because through the, sin entered the world through one man. And then by the grace of God, and Romans 8:28 and Ephesians 9:11, all things work into the good of those who love God. Sin was atoned for also by one man for those who believe in him. Let Yaya's go have another wrap up. No, so Jesus.
Subscribe to Islam Defender.
Oh, yes.
I have only 170.
Okay, I'm going to subscribe today. Okay, so have a look at Yaya's channel. It's called Islam Defender, but is it with the DEF?
Islam Defender, whenever you put Islam Defender straight away.
I think it might be DFENDR. Anyway, do that and then subscribe to Captain Bloodfire. Then subscribe to K Soko Films. Then Soko Studios. Then subscribe to Jesus. You do this by believing in your heart that God raised him from the dead, confessing with your mouth that he is Lord. All the rest will fall into place. If it's not selfish, don't sweat it. And see you later. Yeah, we are back at Speaker School now. I can't believe it, but it's really cold. So let's just wrap this up literally because my coat needs doing up. All right, God bless you all. Love you lots. Bye, bye, bye.